The advantage of our technology is that we can build in protection to a wide range of strains, so that we would hope that one vaccine that we develop would be globally applicable.
Hello, you're watching Proactive. Joining me is Jeremy Salt, CEO of the Vaccine Group, a Frontier IP Group portfolio company. Jeremy, very good to speak to you. Why is your collaboration with Syva significant?
Well, it's significant because of the size of Syva. They're a global animal health company. They've got outlets in more than 70 countries around the world. So they're obviously significant in the world, the market that we play in animal health. One of the key aspects of this collaboration with them is that they have a significant gap in their portfolio of products for pigs, and that's a vaccine for Streptococcus suis. And what this collaboration will give to Syva is an option to negotiate for exclusive world access to this vaccine in all of the markets that they operate in. So from a company point of view, this is essential for us to link with them. In terms of the disease, you know, Streptococcus suis is a highly significant disease for the commercial swine industry. It's present in around 60% of European countries. All intensively farmed pigs around the world suffer from this problem. And one of the big issues with it is that it's one of the major drivers for the use of antibiotics in the livestock and the pig industry. And as I'm sure everybody's aware, yeah, there is a big initiative at the moment to try to reduce the risk of the generation of antimicrobial resistance. So driving down the use of antibiotics through the use of a vaccine like this would be very significant. The one other small element to this is that the disease is actually zoonotic, which means that it can infect people as well and cause significant disease, particularly in Southeast Asia, around food hygiene issues.
Why is CVG's vaccine different, Jeremy?
Well, one of the key issues with the development of Streptococcus suis vaccines in the past has been the strain variation. Probably listeners are familiar to this now after COVID, that strains tend to vary. There are an awful lot in the field geographically distributed around the world with Streptococcus suis. And the vaccines that have been produced in the past have tended to be very specific to individual strains. The advantage of our technology is that we can build in protection to a wide range of strains, so that we would hope that one vaccine that we develop would be globally applicable. It can also be used in very young animals, which is not always the case for all vaccines, and particularly with the conventional Streptococcus suis vaccines. So this is a big advantage, because a lot of the disease that's seen in animals is around the time of weaning, so 6 to 7 weeks of age in pigs, which is, so we can use it right at the right time to target that time when they might be infected. We've actually, you know, we believe from what we've seen so far that the vaccine will be far cheaper, highly significant in the swine market, where it's very competitive, very small margins on products in the swine market. So I think that's a significant advantage that we bring over conventional vaccines that have been used to date. And of course, this builds on a lot of work that's been funded by Innovate UK, British government, by DEFRA in the past, to the tune of about £1 million. With our collaborators, we have a couple of grants that have allowed us to get to this point for the collaboration with Syva, and these have been collaborations with the University of Plymouth and Cambridge, which have been highly significant in allowing us to get to this point.
Jeremy, what else is TVG working on?
Well, we have a platform technology. This is one of our lead candidates. We have a number of other candidates that we've been working on for some time now. Altogether, we have about 12 candidate vaccines. We've expanded so that we can look at both. We started with pigs. We've been expanded this into poultry. Another highly significant recent development for us is that we've just signed another agreement with a UK-based animal health company to work on a poultry vaccine, which may develop into a poultry franchise. So we're very excited about that. And I think that'll be significant for us and for the company. The most recent novel thing that we've been doing with the platform is to look at the ability to deliver biotherapeutics. So these would be seen as monoclonal antibodies, which are a huge advance in both human health and animal health recently. We're now looking with collaborators at whether we can deliver these in a much more, in a cheaper fashion, in a much more amenable fashion, because this is a significant impact on therapeutics, as I say, in both human and animal health. So that's a big new adventure for us.
Jeremy, I hope you'll keep us updated on all of those programs. Thank you very much for speaking with us today.
It's a pleasure. Thank you.
Jeremy Salt is the CEO of the Vaccine Group.